Guys, it's Olga today with you. In this video, I want to talk a little bit more about conflict on the east of Ukraine. This is very old conflict, already 6-7 years, and there is so many talks about it again. But since so many people still ask me, they're not sure, can they travel, not travel, what does it mean, does it, we have war or we doesn't have war, and this recent situation with Russia make the topic just more interested for people, so I decided to give you a very short, brief information, the core of the conflict, what's the problem, how this happened, and what's the solution. So, how it happened. In 2014, Ukraine got revolution and our president escaped to Russia. And with him, there is so many people escaped also, all politicians, so many politicians. And Russia started their occupation of Ukraine. They started from Crimea, which is still now occupied by Russia. Then their plan was to go to so many eastern and south regions of Ukraine to keep very big part for them and to be able to supply to Crimea all the necessary things like water, electricity, and so on, and make themselves the entrance to the Black Sea. That was their basic plans, as a lot of experts are saying, but it didn't work because even if you want to invade some territory, you need local population to support you, because if local population, whatever, so do not support you, you will be keep spending fortunes of money and with no result, because people still will be resisting. So that's what happened actually in Ukraine. They invade Odessa, Kharkiv, Dnipro areas, and these people, local people, was resisting so much. And Russia wasn't able really to keep control in these territories. That's why they dropped them, and they dropped idea to occupy them. And they just focused on Donetsk and Luhansk region, where people was more supportive, and they was resisting more to other Ukrainian special forces help them to kick out these people. And that's why they still have war already 7 years. Many people, actually, the most important question for so many people, is it local war? Are these locals fighting with each other, like Ukraine have part of people who is fighting? Or this is Russia? For sure, this is Russia, but this is with help of locals. As I told you, you cannot have war, you cannot invade territory if locals totally do not support you. But why locals support Russia? I want to tell you a little bit from my point of view how I'm thinking about it. And I will just want to tell you one story, and I'm not sure am I right or not, but this is my point of view. So, in my school, when we was graduating from school, from high school, we was taking pictures to make one book of the pictures in the end of the school. And somebody got an idea that I want just to show you this book, so you really can understand what I'm talking about. This is this kind of book, where is a lot of pictures. And so, we was having one paper where is so many, all the class on the paper. And then we was having paper where is just few people on the paper in a little bit bigger scale. And as you see, we all cut it and pasted on some background. And one girl in our class, she starts saying, no, you need to decide with whom you want to be pasted on the picture, on the paper, on the same paper. And this, you know, we start discussing so much that I don't want to be on one paper with this person. What is this? This is totally nonsense if you will think about it, right? This is not, what the difference? And it turned to a such a big fight in our class that we fight, our class totally got separated to two different camps. And we was to each other like enemies. We didn't talk with other part. We didn't celebrate with them graduation. So we totally got separated, two different classes in one class. And this was something like last 3 or 4 months of our school. We totally didn't talk with each other just because we fight who want to be with whom on the paper. And as you see, this is super stupid reason, but once you pinpoint people attention to some very stupid things, they will start fighting for it, and at the end you will get a huge conflict, and there is no solution even for that, and at the end you don't understand what was your target. I see that in East Ukraine, this is somehow the same idea. So a lot of people say, but people want to be with Russia, people want to speak Russian language. This is all artificial conflict, which Russia, as this one girl in our class who triggered all this huge fight, same, I feel that Russia, she also triggered these things in the people who was living on these territories. This is one part. Another part that always in any community you can find super stupid people who don't want to work, who are searching for easy money. And this is a great target for Russian special forces, or let's say like that. They target these people, they pay them huge money, and they give them tasks. You go spread this information, you go do this task, you go that task. And people who become, after they create this Donetsk and Luhansk republics, the people who become the head of this republics, this is the one who previously was washing the car, another one, this is previously who was working on the market as the guy who is carrying the things. So this is not some people who is with high education, this is not even high education, this is nothing, you know, this is people who all their life, they was totally doing nothing, they have no profession, they have no knowledge, they have no relation, but any mean to any business, government or whatever. They're just some guys who got paid by Russia and they start claiming some things. That's the point of the conflict on East Ukraine. And we reach to the next question, what is the target of this war? And as I told you, the target of our fighting in school was totally nothing. Same, the target of this fight is actually nothing. They was from the beginning officially, after our old president escaped to Russia, and we didn't have any president for 3 months, our parliament elected the head of the parliament who was temporarily responsible to be like a president. This is as per our constitution. And on that moment, these people, they was fighting, we don't recognize this guy, we don't want him, and this is some kind of revolution in Ukraine, and blah, blah, blah. But since that guy was elected, there was already one president elected by all Ukrainians. There now is already second president elected. So why these people still fighting? What they want? What's the target of them? No target, and we all know this is just Russia trying to create instability in Ukraine to not let us join to European Union, not let us join to NATO, and just not to make Ukraine very successful, because if somebody next to Russia is very successful, it's dangerous for Russia, because we all came from Soviet Union, and if Russians will see that Ukraine is much more successful, maybe they can start asking their president why they are more successful, why they live much better than we, and this is what they're afraid. And if you will see to Russian history since a long times, all their target is just to fight with somebody, just to make some great war, just to show to their nation, see, yes, you don't have toilet in your apartment, because in Russia they still have apartments where people have just toilet outside, like I was showing you in these cheap villages in Ukraine, same they have in the cities. Don't look at this, but we are the first in Syria, we are the first in Afghanistan, we go the first on the space. This is this is how they are proud of their things. Some people, they say, but people can choose if they want to live in Russia or they want to live in Ukraine or whatever. My point of view, people personally as individual, he can for sure choose where he want to live. If he want to live in Russia, let him go and live in Russia. Nobody tied him in Ukraine, you know, borders are open, go and live whatever you want. You want to live in US, go to US. You want to live in Africa, live in Africa. Nobody at all forced you to stay in Ukraine if whatever, so you don't like Ukraine. But for example, people who are saying that they have right, this region, this nation, they have right to choose where they want, they are not right, because Ukraine, almost in the whole territory of Ukraine, we have Ukrainians who is living there. These areas like Donetsk, Luhansk, Kiev, Lviv area, Ternopil, and so on, they are not separated for some historical or ethnical reasons. It's more to managerial way to manage the cities better, manage the regions better, because all cities, they have some connection to each other, areas, they have roads which is coming to each other. So all this separation is made just for management. It doesn't have any historical or cultural background. That's why you cannot say that part of Ukraine, people who is just living in this part of Donetsk region. Now they decide we don't want to be part of Ukraine, because Donetsk region by itself, it's like, you know, it's like you have a company and you have a department which is for marketing, department which is for finance, and you have some production department, and finance department decide we don't want to be the part of this company anymore, we just want to be separate company or something like that. And people, and you can say that people have right to choose where they want to be, and what people let them choose, but they cannot bring the whole territory and decide no, this territory should be the other country. This doesn't work in any country, and this doesn't work in Ukraine. That's very simple. If we talk about Crimea, because as I already told, that Russia occupied Crimea, and they claim that this is historically Crimea returns to Russia, and any person who a little bit know history, this doesn't make sense, because for example, if you will start using this excuse, you can, for example, France can claim that they need to have Lebanon for them, or Morocco, or African countries, because they was own them for some period of their existence. Or, for example, Turkey can remember that Ottoman Empire was under caring about Spain, so actually, why not to take Spain back, because this is their historical territory, and it was there since long time. So all these things doesn't make sense, because nowadays the world is not ruling under the who was first on the territory and so on. So Crimea as a semi-island in Ukraine, it also doesn't, it cannot be such a justification of the occupation. And the point with Crimea exactly that Crimea in general, it has some local population. It is much smaller than the whole semi-island, but it is Crimea Tatars, who was deported by Russia in the 20th century, claiming that they was dealing with Germans, with Nazis, with fascists, and they are traitors. So they all deport them to very, very far lands. Imagine, they come to people who was living in this area since ages. They take their houses, they take their land, they take everything, and bring Russians to there to live. And they send local population to some very far areas of Soviet Union at all. And these people had no right to return, even to live in their territory. But in Crimea, even since Ukraine became independent, Ukraine was allowing Russian navy to be located in Crimea. And that was for sure our mistake, because they was always having a lot of Russians, a lot of Russian citizens, for sure Russian citizens. And Russia always, since in Soviet Union and all this history of Russia, they was considering themselves very high nation, and Ukraine, this is very low, stupid nations, which is just somewhere around. So for any Russian to live in Ukraine, to speak Ukrainian language, this is like to go so much down to somebody super stupid. Why at all I need to care about their stupid culture? I'm the higher nation. This is exactly like Nazists are doing, actually. I'm the higher nation, and they're all stupid, you know? So we don't want to speak their language if they force us to speak their state language. What a crazy, what a Nazist, what an anti-Russian things they are doing. They are doing something crazy. They are cutting us on pieces, you know, because they really demand in all governmental places to speak Ukrainian. They demand schools to study Ukrainian, and this is super crazy. This is how they behave, and all the culture of Ukraine, all the things, this is even making them so much furious and so much crazy, because they don't want any remembrance about Ukraine culture. They want to live in our territory and be here as the kings, and to not get bothered by anything at all. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching this video. Sorry that it was a little bit long, but I just tried to explain to them the idea of the conflict, how I see this, how I believe it is. And I'm waiting to read your comments. The comments of Russian trolls for sure will be there. I'm very fine. Write me. And I love you all, guys. Thanks for watching this video. Bye-bye.